Guys, in this video, let us understand speech audiometry. So basically, in pure tone audiometry, what you did, you gave the person pure tone frequencies, right? And you asked that person whether they can hear or not. They just have to say whether they heard or not. That's it. So this will just give you an threshold level for speech audiometry. So you can go one level higher to know whether they can understand speech. Now the person will have to say something. They will have to talk. They'll have to hear, listen, and talk, right? So speech audiometry, two things are there here: speech reception threshold, speech discrimination score. Okay, speech reception threshold, actually they are using two syllable words. Okay, example sunlight, like that, two syllable words. In speech discrimination, they are using monosyllable words like pin, etc. So, but in this speech reception threshold, they'll give very mild intensity, okay? Minimum intensity they will give. So, they will talk so softly and you should repeat this verse. They'll say, sunlight. They should be able to hear it. But in speech discrimination score, they will talk loudly, okay? But you should be able to understand. Pin. You should be able to say pin, okay? Let's see if whatever I said is true. Speech reception threshold. So, minimum intensity you will give at which 50% of the words are repeated correctly. Okay, so you will give two syllable words here like baseball, sunlight, daydream, etc. And the words are delivered from recorded tapes you can give or from monitored voice. Small intensities you will increase. Okay, at least 50% they should recognize. You will know what the threshold is. Okay. Let's move on to speech discrimination score, guys. So basically here what they will give, they'll give you single syllable words like pin, sin, day, bus, right? These are PB, that is phonetically balanced words they will give. So they want to understand whether the patient can understand speech, right? So the percentage of words heard correctly is recorded. What do you see here? This graph looks easy. Look at this. This is decibels. So, more decibels here. So, who needs more decibels? Who has conductive loss? Normal people don't need those many decibels. Okay. And this is that speech percentage. At 30 decibels, they can hear 100%, it seems. Wow. Okay. Now, look at this. Something they're explaining here. Look at this, guys. Basically, this curve here. What they're saying about this one, they're saying, to set the volume of hearing aid, okay. But if you increase the decibels, what happens? There is a fall. Look at this. This fall happens after some level. After 80 decibels, there's a fall. The PB word score falls rather than maintain a plateau, as in cochlear type of sensory neural hearing loss. When you increase the speech intensity above a particular level, the PB word score falls rather than maintain a plateau. Okay. This is some rollover phenomena, guys. So, you understand the rollover phenomena here. Then they are telling for what speech audiometry it is useful. To find the reception threshold, you will find the reception threshold. You will differentiate organic from non-organic functional hearing loss. That is psychological, right? Functional hearing loss. You can fit hearing aid for that. It will help. Then you can differentiate cochlear from retrocochlear hearing loss, right? Look at this. Ability to understand speech and its relation to speech discrimination score. Okay. A list of 50 phonetically balanced words is presented and the number correctly heard is multiplied by 2. So, 90 to 100% if you have score, you are normal, guys. If less than 40, very poor. Okay, this is as simple as that.